Now, today celebrates Australia's most iconic fish. It's National Barramundi Day, and we are joined by Mitch Orr. He's an award-winning chef bending the rules, and you'll understand why in just a few seconds. Welcome, Mitch.
Thank you.
This is awesome. Thank you.
Now, I have to ask, why is the barramundi such a popular fish?
It's like Australia's national fish, I think. It's an Indigenous name. Everyone knows barramundi. It's a really beautiful fish, you know. We should be eating a lot of it. It should be easy to get, and it should be easy to get Australian grown barramundi as well.
Yeah. Oh,
and it's so important, isn't it?
Yeah. And it's funny because you're not the biggest fan of fish, but I feel like barramundi hasn't got that really overpowering
taste.
No,
it's nice and buttery and delicate. Yeah, it's beautiful fish.
Okay. But it's just a treat that you're in here today, and I am going to eat some today. So what are we cooking?
Today?
Yeah.
So we're going to do some fried barramundi wings today. Ooh. So the wing is like the part where the pectoral fin is.
Mm-hmm. Right.
It's really gelatinous and unctuous.
Yep.
So we're going to deep fry it because nothing's better than deep fried fish, right? So do you want to throw some in the buttermilk?
Okay. As in, like, just throw the fish in?
Maybe not make a mess, but...
yeah.
So we're going to...
Gentle.
Some Old Bay spice in there. So It's like a southern style spice, celery seeds.
Beautiful.
Cayenne pepper, etc.
Yeah, keep going.
Put a couple in
more.
We've had the popcorn chicken before, and I really like it. What's the inspiration for this?
So
is that it?
It's that sort of same thing. So if you've got a fillet of fish, you could cut the fillet into popcorn-sized bites and do the same thing.
Yep.
Or if you buy a whole fish, this is sort of a part of the fish that kind of gets wasted. You wouldn't usually use it. So this is a good way, if you're steaming the fillet or grilling the fillet or something, have this as a snack as well, because this is my favourite part of the fish.
Well, what's your benefits? Is it the taste that you love about
this?
Yeah,
it's taste and texture. This is really like a meaty part of the fish, and the texture is really beautiful.
Oh, nice.
So I would leave it, when you do it at home, leave it in the marinade for a couple of hours.
Mm-hmm.
Then when you're ready to fry, can you check the temperature on the fry? Just point that laser in it.
So yeah.
Oh, there you go. Tell me what it is. So then just cornmeal, straight from the buttermilk into cornmeal.
Yep.
163.6.
We can turn it up a little bit maybe.
Crank it up.
About 170.
So what is this particular dish called?
Sorry. I didn't press the button. It's 185.
Oh, too high. Come on.
What's the trick to cooking fish? That's probably the first problem, is it?
Yeah, get the temperature right. That's important. It depends how you're doing it. If you're grilling fish and you want a crispy skin, you should leave it in the fridge uncovered overnight, skin side up, because that allows the skin to dry out, and then you get a nice crispy skin.
Oh, beautiful.
But this way, the cornmeal is going to make it crunchy for us anyway, so we don't have to worry. So once your oil's ready, just a simple crunch, just cornmeal and the buttermilk, drop it in.
Oh, sounds great.
Turn it down a little bit.
Love a bit of a sizzle, right?
Sorry, I mean, this is stupid, but if that was too hot, what was happening? Just burn it straight off.
Yeah, the outside's going to burn and the fish isn't going to cook inside. So you end up with burn outside, raw inside.
That makes
sense. Which is not good.
I'm going to take my glass off.
You can take your glass off.
Anything else when we're cooking fish? I mean...
No, that's it.
Yep.
Seasoning's very important, obviously. So we let that cook for about 3 minutes. We've got some here that we did already. Bit of salt. Bit more of the Old Bay.
Love that.
And can I ask, what was the inspiration behind this particular dish?
So this is like a South of America style, in the deep south. Old Bay seafood is very classical. Usually do a big seafood boil with crawfish and stuff like that, potatoes. Yeah. You'll boil it all together. So it's sort of taking that and just flipping it into a fried dish.
Right. And what are some of the other things you can serve it with?
Yeah, so we're going to serve it today with some pickled green tomatoes, which is sort of a... Southern style thing as well. Green tomato is really popular, but you could just serve it as is. You could serve it with hot sauce.
Okay.
I'm back in.
Pickles, whatever you like. You can treat it just like you treat fried chicken, basically, you know?
Yeah.
So that's awesome. Is this top of your menu now? You recently opened a restaurant in Kiln, which is awesome. Tell us about it. And I heard about the cream ice cream. Or
corn ice cream. So we serve a corn popcorn and salted caramel ice cream. That's really good. I don't really like sweet desserts. I like more savoury desserts.
Oh,
and using vegetables in desserts is really fun as well.
Interesting. I have to try this.
Yeah. Can I eat this?
You can. Go for
it.
Squeeze some lemon on there.
Hey, T-Boz, you want some of this?
How is it just like a chicken wing thing?
Because you can see on the wing there's that little fin in there still.
Yes,
and
right.
Some
so that's
cartilage,
kind of how you hold it. Yeah, yeah.
But you just break it open and suck it down.
Okay.
Oh. Oh.
Good.
All right.
No, I faked it for a minute, but that's actually beautiful. Once it hit the taste palates.
Yeah, it looks good.
I never know a fish. If it's not cooked, it tastes gorgeous. Oh, I'm in.
Nice and crunchy. Mm. The cornmeal does all the work for you. The frying does all the work for you. It's very simple. You can do it at home.
What a day. That is absolutely gorgeous. If you want to find out more about today's National Fish Day, head to australianbarramundi.com.au or go up to Mitch, see the restaurant. That's awesome. Western Sydney doing a proud again. Yeah, you're awesome. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.